नमस्कार. इन स्पिरिचुअलिटी दे से दैट पर्सन शुड नॉट थिंक ऑफ मनी, शुड नॉट हैव मोर मनी, बट दिस इज अ वेरी रॉन्ग कंसेप्ट. एवरी ह्यूमन नीड्स टू ईट फूड वेल, एवरी ह्यूमन नीड्स अ शेल्टर, एवरी ह्यूमन हैज टू डू सो मेनी एक्टिविटीज, ट्रैवलिंग एंड सो मेनी अदर थिंग्स, दैट वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज मनी. एंड जस्ट बिकॉज यू आर फॉलोइंग अ पाथ ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी एंड विच आई थिंक सो एवरी ह्यूमन शुड फॉलो, not respecting money would be wrong. See the example given in Ramayana. Raja Janak, a great yogi, but he was a king and he was living like a king, wearing like king, wearing all the jewels and everything. That doesn't make him that he is not spiritual or he is materialistic. No. Understand that when you are attached with something, then you are gone. But if money is there, you use it. Money is not there, you can live with just a simple food and hardly anything on the body, no problem. So understand one point thoroughly well, that don't mix this spirituality and remaining simple and not having more money. This thinking has to go. Person has to respect money. Person has to live a spiritual path. Both are going together. People say that money can't buy happiness. You don't get happiness with money. Money can't buy love. Money can't buy faith. Money can't buy hunger. Money can't buy sleep. Money can't buy time. Peace. All this money can't buy. So, do you think money is not important? In Vedas, it is mentioned that everybody needs money for his survival. And why money is given that status of God in our culture? Lakshmi ji represents money. Lakshmi ji talks about mangal, shubha, labh. Money is required. So all this shows that money is important and we have to respect money. Do you know how much cash you are carrying right now in your pocket? Do you know how much you have spent precisely for this whole month? Do you make budget plans for the month and follow it religiously? Do you know where you have kept your last bill of purchase? All these questions will tell you how much you respect money. Understand, money too has its own limitation. We have to bring balance between all the other activities and earning money. Spending day and night earning money is wrong, and not giving importance to other aspects is equally wrong. So we have to bring balance. In this 24 hours, how much time should I spend for earning money? How much time for other activities? We should be very much clear about. This argument that money can't buy this and that, fine, but we should know what money can buy. Number one, money can buy basic comforts. In today's this congested space, only money can buy you a comfortable living house. You may have strength to breathe in, but the air is not in your control. Only money can buy you residential place of pure and natural health. You may choose to have a right food habits, calories and this and that. Only money can buy you a quality food grades and materials. You may choose to have a child, but only money can buy you a good school and all the infrastructure. So, money buys you the basics. Do not ignore it, respect it. Second point, money helps you to pursue your dreams. To dream, you don't require any money, but to pursue your dream, you need money. I know a person who wanted to go for a higher study, but because of lack of money, he couldn't do that. He couldn't take an admission for the higher study. So, money can buy you resources to fulfill your passion, to fulfill your dreams, and to fulfill your fascination. Third point, money can buy you security. It can make you fearless and remove the worry about future. Money can help you to live in the present. The availability of cash in your pocket ensures that you are not getting fluctuated by the fluctuation of market standard. When the financial crisis comes, the rich don't get affected. Rather, they go for shopping spree. Security is something which poor people actually struggle with. For your comforts, dream and security, the money is the only thing? No. Your lifestyle, your attitude, your health, your relatives and relations around you and the people around, and so many other factors are involved to make you happy and healthy. You should know that great drawbacks of just concentrating on money and ignoring all the other aspects. And you should know not giving more importance to money and spending more time in other activities are also wrong. How to manage money? Let us understand. There is a formula here. There is a ratio here. 1:2:1. And the formula is that after you have completed your existential needs, then the money which you have has to be divided like this. Whatever you are earning, use only 50%, half of that in your day-to-day activity. 1/4 you should keep it for the future as a security, and 1/4 you should use for the good of humanity. That 1/4 which you are giving for the society is so much important, because society is helping us to live our life. So we have to see that all good things in the society are supported. And so here we should contribute to the world with our money. Somehow we should respect money. We should try and see that we use money systematically. We use money to even help others, to see that the society progresses. One, doing duty towards yourself, near and dear, society, nation, humanity. And if this formula is kept in mind, you would be really living life perfectly. So, take charge of yourself. Namaskar.